A new study by AccountTemp shows more than half, 52% of workers say they're stressed at work every day.
And more than 60% say it's only gotten worse in just the last 5 years alone. Alana Brookbanks is with AccountTemp. Elena, welcome back to Live at 9.
Thank you. This is kind of alarming.
Yeah, it has been. All right, let's break it down. How stressed out are we these days?
Well, the survey looks like we're pretty stressed out, especially when you break down the numbers. The 18 to 34-year-old category has the highest amount of stress,
really?
Over 60%. And then 34 to 55, about 59, and then it tapers from there.
Okay.
So kind of the younger work crowd seems to be bearing the most of the stress.
Any idea why?
Well, you look at your Generation Zers, and technology is so huge, and wanting to learn all that technology and be the part of the first things that come out. Sometimes you have to teach people how to prioritize.
Right.
And then work-life balance at that age group.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Now, in the last 5 years or so, Elena, are we taking work home more so? Is work with us everywhere we go these days because of technology that you spoke of?
Absolutely. You know, they cited in the poll three kind of things, which were increased demands in workload, but also deadlines, work-life balance, bosses putting too much expectation on their employees. But you have to look at technology.
Mm-hmm.
As great as it is, I'm sure most of us have a computer at work, a tablet we take home, and a cell phone, and you're accessible all the time. So even if something's not demanding of you, it's that urge to feel like, I need to respond now, or why hasn't that person responded in the last 5 minutes?
Right.
Because you have access all the time. It's so hard to turn it off.
Interesting.
So how does an employee, and I'm sure employers, that this will work out where employers recognize that and begin to take steps, but it probably will have to come like from the ground up with employees saying, I'm drawing a line. How do you do that and feel safe?
That's a really good question. You know, there's a lot of different ways to de-stress, and you can certainly take some of that on yourself.
Okay.
But at some point, if it's not going away and it's a day-to-day stress, you have to go to your boss. And I think there's a right way to do it, which is showing the workload that you have, showing what you're doing, and asking for help. Asking for additional resources, training on new technologies. There's so many different ways. If it's a work-life balance, I know Robert Half gives us an EAP program, an employee assistance program, that may have to help with some taking care of some things from a home life balance standpoint.
Got you.
Can we do that, though, in a way that still makes us seem, at least in the boss's eyes, that we can be productive?
Absolutely. I think you just have to show the information. You have to show what you're doing, show the deadlines that are being brought to you. And it's important for bosses to have some fun in the workplace.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it's just as easy as taking your group out to lunch. You know, one person is stressed, and that can create an entire team of stress, and productivity will go very low very quickly.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So if I'm a boss and I have an employee who is stressed out and comes to me, not only is it important for that employee to find some ways to help them, but it's going to affect everybody.
Gotcha.
Does there also, from the employer standpoint, need to be more training on all the new technologies? Because you may have the younger folks wanting to engage and learning that fast, but maybe the boss, who's a different generation,
Absolutely.
Is a little slow to go, okay, let's learn how to do this from a corporate standpoint. Does that
make
sense?
Absolutely. The training is imperative. I know we have been given so many wonderful tools over the past few years to make our jobs easier, but it doesn't become easier until you learn how to use the tools correctly.
Right.
And trying to self-teach can be a little intense when you're also trying to do your job.
Mm-hmm.
So having the resources, whether it's from a corporate standpoint or a trainer or mentor, it's huge. Difference.
So, but you may have to step up as the employee and say, can't ask for us to do this if you have not trained us how to do this.
Yes. And ask for a mentor, ask someone to show you how to use the tools better.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Elena, very good information. Glad to have you back.
Oh, nice to see you all again.
Good to see you as well.